So the sleep quality varies, right? You're saying sometimes a deep sleep will happen, sometimes sleep doesn't, deep sleep doesn't come. So from a purely body point of view, okay, from the body point of view perspective, a person cannot get deep sleep if there's a hormonal or chemical imbalance in the body, right? So there is a hormone called melatonin, which is released by the pineal gland. What you call a so-called third eye. So that melatonin hormone is responsible for sleep pattern or even meditation pattern. So that is sensitive to light. Sensitive to light. So in very deep darkness, it helps your body to relax and go to sleep. So that hormone is called melatonin, and the rhythm of the body, waking up, dreaming, deep sleep, is called circadian rhythm. So the melatonin hormone is responsible for circadian rhythm. So for all you know, the melatonin hormone response may not be okay. Why it is not okay? There may be disturbance in that, whatever reason. So typically the disturbance because light, some small light is there in the room, still the body, the gland starts, still thinks it's a daytime. Okay, that's one. Second thing is, you have gone with the too many thoughts. So thoughts, you have gone into a dreamlike state. Okay, which means the brain is still, the thoughts are still coming up in the brain. So the body has relaxed, but the brain is still functioning because the brain is not gone into a silent mode. Thoughts are rising and that becomes the dream. So because you are dreaming still, the body function is going on. You are not able to relax into a deep sleep state. So sometimes you slip a bit into deep sleep and again you come back with the thought. The thoughts are coming and going. So you have to quieten down before you slip into deep sleep. Now why thoughts are coming? The thoughts are coming because your morning activity has created a lot of impression. So those impressions have created a thought pattern. So the thought pattern is not settled to allow you to go to deep sleep. So you have to relax. Everything, the body function has to come to minimum. The brain function has to come to minimum before you can go into sleep. But brain function is not coming to minimum because even the body is not moving, the brain is continuously chattering. That has to relax. Then you'll slip into deep sleep. The quality of sleep, right, is depend on this. One is that the hormone creation, melatonin. Second thing is the impressions you have in the morning. Somebody is too much worried about life. Okay, too much thinking about life. So that the brain doesn't stop thinking. It continues or try to organize that thought process. So it's continuously going on doing. So the brain doesn't rest. Doesn't go to a resting state. Because continuously there is a thought and it's like a dream, like coming up, going down. It's because of too much of stress or worry in the morning, daytime. Right? So then other thing is possibly you are not going to deep sleep because your body is not tired enough. See, body has to be tired for it to go to sleep. If the body doesn't get tired, so the body is still active. So the mind is still holding on to the body because body is functional and active. So you're not going back to sleep. You're not going to slipping into deep sleep. Your energy level is high, right? So my sister's daughter was there. It is very difficult to make her sleep because her energy level is so high. She has to keep on playing, okay? And everybody gets tired, but she doesn't get tired.
So then what happens is that when you take her to bed, she's afraid that she'll fall asleep. So she'll keep her eyes open like this. She doesn't want to fall asleep. So energy level is so high, the body doesn't, body is not tired. So then definitely you don't fall into sleep.
Right? Possibly.
Then another thing is there, your breathing pattern is disturbed. So what happens is some people have a, snoring problem. When you snore, the oxygen level in the body is not, the oxygen which you are taking in the body is reduced. So now that causes the disturbance in sleep. Sleep gets disturbed. So these are some of the factors I know where the sleep quality can vary.
Another factor is that, you know, if you are sleeping when your food is not digested. I mean,
yes, the body is not, body is still working.
Yeah. It's when that is
so
working.
So the body has a body has a, that is actually helpful as well as not helpful.
Yeah, for some people.
See, what happens is that our stomach is our stomach is a long pipe. It's a 30-40 feet pipe. Right? 40 feet. So now it's like a pipe. When you eat, take the food. The food takes different time to travel.
Yes.
Through the body. Right? The fruits take 3 hours. Vegetable takes 5 hours. Okay?
Traveling time. Up to a large point.
And then your grains take 7 to 8 hours.
Oh. Okay.
Now this food has to be digested. So it has to be powdered, it has to be grinded like that. So it has to take constant contraction and release movement is happening. The stomach is contracting, releasing. So that means your body is active. Even though it's not a conscious activity, it's just a subconscious activity which is going on, or autonomous activity is going on. Pipe. So now because of that, what will happen to you? Two things happen. For running that pipe, body, you need energy. Okay? So energy means the blood has to, the blood and energy has to be supplied to that. So normally what will happen, the blood and energy which is going to the brain is reduced. It will go to the body, stomach. So that's why if you eat very good food, you feel drowsy. All the blood circulation, energy circulation is going towards the stomach. Right? So for the brain, the energy supplies or blood supply or energy supplies reduced. So you start feeling drowsy. That's why when you eat a heavy meal, you start feeling sleepy. Now, if you don't eat heavy meal, your stomach is empty. The stomach is not getting more blood supply. It means your brain is active. That means your energy levels for the brain is high. So it's very likely that you may not have a good sleep. All right. So the third condition is that, okay, you got into sleep, but some digestion is not happening properly. So a lot of activity going on. Okay.
That disturbs
the sleep.
The best thing is to